Now I come back. That was terrible.
I know.
Come back. So you go to the corner, make sure the dog is always so the idea of moving the dog, the judge wants to see how the dog looks when he's going away and when he's coming back. So you're the judge. And so I told you to go down. This is what you do. And then after here it starts spinning out. So like you lost all your chance. So you have to start. So put your dog down here. And then probably like this distance from the judge. Place the dog in front of the judge. Right? And from here, start walking away in a good speed. And when you turn around, stop. Look at the judge. So the dog comes straight to the judge, so the judge stands in the front. So your job is to keep the dog steady and then one simple speed. Good. Understand? And stop away from the judge so the judge can see the profile of the dog. Okay? So for that, you're gonna have to keep your leash tighter and closer to the dog. Because if I wanna move the dog from here to this leash, I can move it.
Pretty much.
And I can move the dog here. But if I keep all this leash,
he follows me around.
The dog doesn't move.
You
have no control. But by the time you wanna cut the dog, you have to move like really far away from here, okay? Right? So you turn and back. Take your time. What I normally do, you have the dog here, right? The judge goes over, tip. Alright? And you say, okay, come down. You're going down and back. What you're going to do is, before you turn the ground, you're going to fix your pole. By the way, this is in the wrong way.
Decide where she wants to walk.
Okay. So this is the way
the
color works. Right. When you give a correction, they release.
So
correction, they release. You see how the ring comes up and down? So the other way.
It's not her fault. I find her really well. Yeah.
So the other way, you pull, and the ring is up. So it's not working.
I can go on her anywhere,
right?
Anytime.
So just make sure every time the dog is